Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to build a Pro Tools template for the Clasp. A Pro Tools open, select New Session, select our sample rate, which in this case is 48K, blank session, click OK. So now we've got a blank Pro Tools session here. So the first thing we need to do is we need to set up some basic things in Pro Tools. Go to Pro Tools Preferences. Under Mixing tab, make sure that these three things have check marks in them, especially this third one, Scroll to Track Banks Controllers. Under MIDI, you want to make sure that you're not sending anything out to the Clasp. So for example, any sort of MIDI click or MIDI note numbers, MIDI machine control, you want to turn that off. You don't want that. Operation, this is all personal preference here. Let's go to next part, which will be playback engine. We need to make sure we turn on delay compensation. Delay compensation can be either short or long with Clasp, but doesn't make any difference. You do need to make sure it's turned on though. So turn that on. And the next thing we need to do here is peripherals. We need to set up Huey. Okay, so if you've got your Clasp connected to your MIDI interface and the MIDI interface is turned on and working and the Clasp is powered up, next thing you're gonna do is you're gonna establish Huey on just the first slot here under your peripherals MIDI controllers. So let's set Huey. And in this case, we're gonna set the receive port to port B and the send port is also port B. And just click OK. Next thing we need to do is we need to make some tracks. We're going to make 24 tracks, mono. On the first track, we're going to put the Clasp plugin here. This is the Clasp bridge plugin, or remote. And we're going to set the MIDI ports on the Clasp plugin to match those of the Huey, which are port B. So you notice right here on the Clasp plugin, you've got this little drop-down menu that says MIDI port. Click on this. You've got your input port and your output port. Each of these we're going to set to port B. All right, so there it goes. So now the Clasp is updated. It's talking to the hardware. You can see it's already cycling through the channels and updating. All right, so now we've got our 24 channels. We want to make sure we have track number turned on. Now, this is personal preference. You don't have to have track number turned on, but of course it's really good because Clasp is using MIDI machine control and Huey for track arming. Every track and its position is critical. You don't want to get the tracks out of order with the I/O. Since a tape machine is a physical device that's hardware and it's physically patched into a matrix, you've got to make sure that your track positions are matching up the actual physical patch as it corresponds with the Clasp hardware. Okay, so now that you've set up your 24 channels, make sure that your inputs are all in consecutive order, cascading down, down the line, 1 through 24, each input corresponding with the physical location of each track. Input 1, channel 1, input 2, channel 2, and so forth. Once you have that, you want to do the same thing with your outputs. Consecutive order, and there we go. All right, so all 24 outputs are set. Now the next thing we need to do, let's make a new mono master fader. And on this mono master fader, we want to assign Clasp machine sync plugin, one instance. You can see on this plugin here, it's got the tape machine indicator and the green sync indicator lets us know that it is properly synchronized. And here's our offset values over here on the right. It's one channel. Let's go ahead and duplicate this. This is a fast way of doing this. Let's duplicate it. Let's do 23. All right. So now we have 24 mono master faders set up. And now we just need to set the outputs. And unfortunately, Pro Tools doesn't have a way that you can cascade your outputs with master faders. So you have to manually put these in. Make sure that you don't miss any outputs. If you were to skip outputs, that would cause your delay compensation to turn red and the Clasp would not properly operate and your audio would not be timestamped correctly. Now that you've got those set up, flip back to your arrange window, check your delay compensation indicator, which is right here, and make sure it's green. Green is good. If this were to be red, then your delay compensation would not be functioning correctly, and Clasp would not be able to timestamp the audio to compensate for the tape synchronization. So now that you've got these set up here, these master faders, you can just hide them. You don't need to look at them at all. Just hide them in the background, and what you end up with here is basic template. You got your Clasp bridge plugin, got all your Clasp machine sync plugins, 24 channels set up. You can bank between your channels here. Let's try arming a few tracks and see if we can get the tape machine to roll. Great, tape's rolling. So here's one thing. If the tape is not rolling for you and you're wondering, why isn't my tape machine rolling? It's probably because either your tape's offline or you don't have any tracks armed in Pro Tools. If you really want the tape to roll, you've got to have tracks armed. And then you'll get this green indicator. You know it's rolling. Another really important thing we need to set up here is Quick Punch. We need to make sure Quick Punch is enabled. With Quick Punch turned on, you'll be able to punch in and out with the tape and the clasp. And the Quick Punch with clasp is what makes clasp amazing. So make sure you've got your Quick Punch turned on. Now that you've created your clasp template, let's save it as a clasp template. So save as template, and you can pick your category and put it in custom folder, wherever you'd like to place it. And you're set. You've got a clasp template now. So this is the basic 24-channel clasp template that we've just created. However, a lot of people want to have click track running, perhaps some pre-production that's running. And if you want to do that sort of thing and fill all 24 tracks on an analog tape machine at the same time, you're going to want to set up some additional master fader outputs. This particular Pro Tools rig, we only have 24 outputs, so we wouldn't be able to do that. However, let's say you had 32 outputs and you wanted to use the first 24 just for the analog machine and then the remaining 8 for a click or some vocal stems or other stems, stereo, you know, stems coming out. Then what you'd do is you'd create an additional 8 mono master faders just like these that we created initially, and you would assign the outputs to those as well all the way up through output 32. Or if it was 48 outputs, then you would do through 48. We want to make sure that we've got our connections correct. So double check the connection diagram. Make sure you have the sync in and out on the clasp connected to one of the channels on your tape deck. Put the tape machine in repro, and you want to make sure you arm all the tracks on the machine. When you're using clasp, it's a good idea to just leave all the tracks armed on the machine always. The clasp does not control the arming of the tape machine. It controls the arming of the clasp itself for monitor control.